Hi guys, it's Suzanne. Behind me on the TV are my lost TV interviews from 6 years ago. This is what color my hair is supposed to be. That's what color I dyed it by mistake 6 years ago. So enjoy my two videos.
Shirley Temple, no child performer before or since has been bigger, and no one appreciates that more than collector, author, and local resident Suzanne Krause Mancuso. Suzanne's latest book celebrates Shirley Temple's 75th birthday. It's also a collecting guide for all things Shirley. We have it right with us. You'll get a better look at it. You'll get a look at some of the things if you stay with us. Thanks for joining us here on Daytime.
Oh, wonderful to be here.
And you know that we just had the song about the lollipops, and we have a little lollipop with Shirley Temple.
A little gift.
Picture right in there. We have it. It's good looking, isn't it? That's good looking. No, better looking than me. I know that's true. All right. And I see so many stuff here. First of all, how did you get involved in all this?
I began collecting as a child because my grandmas were both big Shirley fans, and one thing led to another, and two books later, here we are.
Because I was going to say, you're way too young to sort of have grown up with Shirley Temple. Even if you grew up in the 50s, you saw her on television a lot, but you're younger than that.
I'm considered the third generation of Shirley fans.
Okay.
The original fans were from the 1930s, and you know, grandma or mom. Basically, back in the 50s, she came out with her own TV show, and there was another group of fans that my mother would fall into, and now then there's me. And then my children, of course, will be the next generation of fans.
I'm sure that with all the DVDs that are coming out now,
absolutely.
You can't miss it.
Fox had to get on the roll, too. They had to get all her videos back.
Oh, really? They went out and bought them again?
Well, they re-released them in color, because their originals were all in black and white, as you saw on the prompter.
Sure.
You know, she's in color, and they're absolutely beautiful to watch.
Let's talk about Shirley a little bit and some of the things you have for us in front of us here that
sure.
I'm looking at. And I see there is Captain January, which, of course, is at the Codfish Ball.
Yes.
And Come Along and Follow. What is the other song from that?
There's quite a few songs. But her most popular song, which you just saw, was on the Good Ship Lollipop. The Codfish Ball is one of my favorite songs. My husband and the kids all sing it all the time, and they make fun of me.
Can you sing it a little bit?
Come along and follow me to the bottom of the sea.
Well, we're back together. That's great. Let's move on. But that's a great book. Now, when did this book come out? Because it celebrates two movies at the same
time.
That's
actually a vintage 1930s book that came out to commemorate the movies, of course, and the children would collect them and get to read the stories if they couldn't get to the movie to watch it.
Okay, I know. I've got the big book in front of me.
That's the big book.
And this is more than a catalog when we talk about this. I mean, you have the whole history in here. You have so many artifacts and stuff. I've got to open this up a little bit, too. I mean, you've got everything in here. You tell a history of the things. I mean, how much of this do you happen to possess yourself?
I have a large collection, but the books are a conglomerate of many collectors through many years. Leslie Tannenbaum is a collector in Yorktown, and she provided me with many of the pictures of the items that I didn't have myself.
Now, we have one more. They have something up here I definitely have to talk about. It's at the end of the table, and it's a can of soda. You know, so we call that, what, an anachronism? Because it wasn't there when Shirley Temple was popular.
That was made in the 1980s, and I believe there was a president, Jimmy Carter, that had beer made after him. That, well, in that case, they made Shirley Temple soda pop.
Well, it was also Ronald Reagan's time, so of course I can understand
absolutely.
Why it might be popular at that point.
Everyone has their thing, and I collect odd things.
Another thing, so in addition to that, Shirley Temple... What is that little thing?
Those are 8mm movies, and they were made in the 30s and 40s for the little projectors. I don't have a projector because that's still sealed. I don't want to open it.
When you talk about vintage, it is in mint condition and vintage. Suzanne, thanks very much for being with us.
It was wonderful to be here.
Shirley, right here for being with us as well and holding up our flowers. Also, we're talking about Shirley Temple, and thank you very much. And I'll hold this up one more time so we can look at this. A great catalog for you Shirley Temple fans out there. And up next, we're going to talk about summers, wedding fever, and the hottest new trends in Westchester wedding jewelry when Daytime returns.
Suzanne is all over it. Suzanne is all over it. Take a look at this.
In the 1930s, Shirley Temple was America's child movie star sweetheart.
She's very glad to see you.
The curly-haired little girl sang and danced her way to cinematic fame before she could even read or write. A true superstar, she made some 50 films over a 15-year period, memorizing entire scripts.
I never pretended as good as this before.
It's been a number of years now since Shirley retired from public life, but you've never known that by visiting this house in Peekskill, New York.
Hi, welcome to Shirleyville.
This is the home of Suzanne Mancuso, a serious devotee to all that is Shirley Temple.
The world is a harsh place, and sometimes you need to find things in life that make you happy, and Shirley songs and collecting Shirley dolls, it's really what makes me happy.
Got the
M-M-I-L-E. She's just one of those happy people. You can't help but smile when you look at one of her movies.
Suzanne's home is stuffed with Shirley memorabilia. Her dolls alone number more than 300. There's sheet music, books, a tea set, even a bag of Shirley marbles. For Suzanne, it's all Shirley all the time.
I have records, posters, postcards, DVDs.
Temple is the only child star who maintained consistent box office drawing power for years, and her likeness flooded the Depression-era marketplace.
I collect Shirley Temple pictures. A lot of them were from the Fox studios, but a lot of them were candid photos from family members or other executives that would take candid photos of her.
So before Barbie, there was Shirley. And for dedicated fans like Suzanne, Shirley will always be close to heart.
She just brings such joy to my life. And I think that's where it all stems from, just finding the simple joys in life.
Well, Suzanne's hobby actually has the full support of her family.
It's better.
She does cringe a little bit every time she brings home a new piece of memorabilia, because you can imagine their house is absolutely chock full of stuff. So if you want more information, you can see our website at fox5ny.com. And in case you want some more information, I'd like to distribute these books.
Oh,
if you'd perhaps like to make an investment yourself.
Very good. Amazing what she could do in 15 years, though.
Well, if I'm not mistaken, when she grew up, she became Shirley Temple Black.
That's right.
And a member of Congress.
Yes, she did. She's had a very healthy life. Yeah. Very well,
all right, we'll be back with a look at the weather. And
that's
of course,
right. I cringe every time she brings something else in new.
And that was our TV interviews from 6 years ago. Bye.